morning, everybody. Inshallah, today we will discuss introduction about nodal analysis. Our lecture has the following content. We will know what is the producing system or what is the production system. Also, we will know what is the nodal analysis and what is the pressure and pressure drop in the system. Also, the objective of the nodal analysis will be discussed, and finally we will know the node location and the requirement for the nodal analysis. So what is the objective of this lecture? First, to understand the basic principle of petroleum production system and to study the objective of the nodal analysis. Also, the objective is to understand the principle used to perform nodal analysis, and finally to study how to select the optimum node location based on the objective of the nodal analysis. As we have discussed before, the compression can be gasket or open hole compression. So in gasket compression, we have the perforation that has a surface or surface between reservoir and well oil. Also, we have number four, there may be production through production. We have number four, there may be a production through tubing or through casing. Through casing also may be through casing and tubing without pipes. Also, the production may be only through tubing. So, if we propose or suppose that a production through tubing with packer, the producing system, we can define it as the system which is required to move a liquid from its original location in the reservoir through the perforation and through tubing, through furrow lines to the separator or cell lines. There may be also some restrictions inside the tube. Maybe there is a surface safety valve or subsurface safety valve. Maybe there is a surface choke located in the wellhead or behind the separator. So the producing system is known as the system that can be used to move a liquid from its original location in the reservoir through perforation and tubing, flow line, and any restrictions in the wells. Any producing system can be subdivided to two categories. The first category is simple producing system, and the other category is complete or complicated producing system. So what is the simple producing system? A simple producing system, as can be shown in the figures, is a producing system without any restrictions inside the tubing or the flow line. So the fluid will move in the pipes without any restrictions. And in the ideal case, we call it a simple producing system. Another type of a producing system is a complete or a complicated producing system. We can see the difference between the two producing systems. There is some restrictions inside the tube and inside the flow line. This may be chop or safety path. So we call it a complete producing system. In the simple or a complete producing system, we can perform the nodal analysis to optimize the system. So what is the nodal analysis? The nodal analysis is referred to the techniques that can be used to analyze or optimize all the components of the producing system based on the reservoir capacity. That we can say the most important component in the producing system is the reservoir, because it tells us which fluid we will produce and how many fluids we will produce. Any production system or producing system may consist of reservoir, perforation if it is casing hole, also tubing if it is produced, with a tubing and buffer, and flow line and separator. We have known before that the reservoir pressure, which we call it PR or the average reservoir pressure, is the pressure inside the reservoir. And there is a pressure also in the sand phase if there is perforation. We call it PWFS. Also, there is a bottom hole flowing pressure, and there is a well head pressure, and there is a separator pressure. Any producing system can produce under one of two conditions. The first one is the well can produce under constant separator pressure. In this case, the flow line will affect the flow of the liquid from the well bore to the separator. The second case, that the well will produce under constant well head pressure, which is mostly used, and in this case, no effect for the flow line in the production system or in the producing system. And we can say the system will be aided by the well head. So the well can be produced under separator pressure, constant separator pressure, and the system will be aided by the separator. Or it can produce under constant well head pressure, and the system here will be aided by the well head. There are two constant pressures in any producing system. The first one is the reservoir pressure or the inlet pressure, and the second one is the well head pressure or the separator pressure. So when we consider the constant pressure in the well head, and when we consider the separator as the constant pressure, we have two categories of wells. One can produce under constant well head pressure. In this case, we say the constant pressure is the well head pressure. And if the well is producing under constant separator pressure, we call the second constant pressure is the separator pressure. So in any producing system, there is two constant pressure. One is the inlet, and we can mainly say the second one is the outlet pressure. Either it is the well head or it is the separator. After that, we want now to say what is the pressure drop in the system. We know that there is a big relation between fluid movement and pressure drop. So the final or the total pressure drop in any producing system will be the inlet pressure minus the outlet pressure. Either the outlet will be the well head or will be the separator. This will include what? If this is the inlet pressure and we consider the following producing system with some restrictions and have a separator, so the well here is producing under constant separator pressure, we can say the total pressure drop is equal to reservoir pressure minus separator pressure, which includes pressure drop due to permeability in reservoir, pressure drop in perforation due to packing in the case of gravel packing. Also, there is a P pressure drop in the tube and a pressure drop in the flow line. Also, with P pressure drop in any restrictions inside the pipes. So mainly we can say the pressure drop in a producing system is pressure drop through reservoir plus pressure drop in perforation, pressure drop in tubing plus pressure drop in flow line and in restriction cells. This will be equal to the total pressure drop, which is equal to reservoir pressure minus the outlet pressure, which here is the separator pressure. After that, we want now to say or to understand what is the objective of the rotor analysis. We have discussed that the producing system composed of many components. We now want to know what is the objective of the technique we call it novel analysis. The objective of this system is to understand or to determine the flow rate which an existing well will produce. And presently equipped, we will not change any component, we only want to know what is the production rate in the present case. Another objective is to determine under what flow conditions the well will load or die. We have known before that the effect of diameters in fluid mechanics and flowing pipes, there will be effect in the flow or the flow rate if we have changed the diameters. And sometimes if a tubing or two big tubing have been used, so the velocity of the liquid will reduce and this will load the well. In this case, the well will die. So we want to know what is the condition that leads the well to die. Also, the objective of the nodal analysis is to analyze the separator pressure and to select the optimum tubing size, also the flow line size, surface and subsurface choke, or the subsurface safety valve, also to analyze the effect of perforation depth. We have seen before that the perforation depth can be neglected as it is very small if there is no sump control methods have been used. However, when we use sump control methods, which you call it gravel banking, the perforation will have a big pressure drop, so we can neglect it. Also, we can use the production system analysis or nodal analysis to analyze or to evaluate well stimulation. And we can check every component in the producing system to see if it is restricting or have restrictions in the production rate or not. Finally, the objective of the nodal analysis, or the nodal analysis can be used to select the time for the artificial lifting method or the gas lifting. After we have known the objective of the nodal analysis, we now want to see the node location. What is the node location? In fact, any component in the producing system can be used as a node location, depending on the target or the objective of the model. So, if we want to isolate the effect of the tubing size, the node will be before the tubing begins. So, the bottom hole condition will be used as a node location. Also, to evaluate the well performance or well stimulation, we prefer the node location to be the bottom hole condition. Another node location is the well head. The node well head can be selected as a node location in two cases. The first case, to isolate the effect of the flow line. In this case, if the flow line has an effect in the producing system, the separator pressure or the well will produce under cholesterol separator pressure. So we consider the separator pressure and we consider the flow line. The second case in which the well head can be selected under node location is to isolate the effect of the well head in the producing system if the well head or the well producing under cholesterol well head pressure. So we have cholesterol well head pressure or cholesterol separator. If we have a cholesterol well head pressure, then the well head pressure will be selected as a node location. Or if the well will produce it under cholesterol separator pressure, and we want to isolate the effect of the flow line, so the well head also can be selected as a node location. Another node location is the separator, to isolate the effect of the separator pressure in the producing system. Also, across the completion intervals, the perforation or perforated interval, we can select a node location in the perforated interval itself to isolate the effect of perforation depth, shot per feet. how many shot per minute or what is the optimum shot per minute. We have seen before to select or the effect of the perforation density can be studied only in the case of gravel packing. Another location for the load can be surface chop or subsurface chop or any restriction in the system can be also selected as a load location depending on the target or the objective of the load. So the following loads can be selected as the load location depending on the target of the normal time. Now let us know what is the requirement to perform nodal analysis. There is two requirements to perform nodal analysis. The first requirement is that flow to the node, any node, the flow into the node is equal to the flow out of the node. That if the reservoir, for example, has the ability to give 500 barrels per day, so the other component has to handle the 500 per day. So the inflow to the node will be equal to the outflow to the node. Only one flow rate exists in all the components. The other requirement is that any node have one pressure. That pressure can be calculated from the in or from the out component. So the two requirements is first the inflow to the node is equal to the outflow to the node. We can select any node, so the inflow to this node would be the outflow also. Only one flow rate or Q exists. The other requirement is that any node here has only one pressure. As we have seen before, this pressure we call it reservoir pressure. So we have only one reservoir pressure. Also, the sand phase pressure. Node 7 is the sand phase or the perforated interval. The pressure exists here is the sand phase pressure. We call it BWFS. So the well will have BWFS for one flow rate. If we change the flow rate, the flow, the pressure is the node will be changed. However, for a constant flow rate, there will be only one pressure. Node 6, if we selected node 6, the bottom hole flowing pressure is the pressure in the node. The well will produce flow rate, constant flow rate. The BWF will be, we will not change the BWF. We can see that the BWF can be calculated from the reservoir pressure using flow-through porous medium. Also, the bottom hole flowing pressure can be calculated from the separator using the flow in pipes equations. So, the procedure, what is the procedure to perform another analysis? We can have five or four steps. The first step is to select an objective. What do you want by nodal analysis? After that, you can select the node location depending on the target or the objective. After that, you divide the system to two parts, in and out flow. We can see this. Yeah? If we selected node 6, for example, as a solution, we can divide the system to two parts, inflow to the node and outflow to the node. And after that, we calculate the pressure drop in the upstream component and the pressure drop to the downstream component using different equations for pressure drop in the pipes or in the reservoir. And we will stop now. In the next lecture, we will know how to perform nodal analysis using different node locations. And thank you, everybody. If you have any questions, we are ready for that. Thank you.